Overnight sailing passages can be tricky, and every sailor knows squalls usually hit in the dark, early morning hours. Sailing from Linton Bay, Panama to Bocas Del Toro means we have to cross the shipping lanes of the Panama Canal, so we need to keep a close watch and avoid the many cargo ships transiting these waters. It's a bit nerve-wracking, but we are ready to move on, and there's still a bit of time before the weather is right for our next big journey.
We are sailing today. We're on passage from Linton Bay to Bocas Del Toro, which is about 150 nautical miles west, close to the Costa Rican border. We may stop at Isla Escudo de Veragas, which is about 25 nautical miles from Bocas, weather permitting, because it's a bit exposed, so we want to be able to anchor in a protected place. But at Escudo de Veragas, it's supposed to be a beautiful island with lots of gorgeous reef and tons of fish. So hopefully we can stop there. It has been about 6 or 7 weeks since we've sailed, and so we're working out the kinks today. So we filmed a bit getting off the dock, but after that we had to just focus on sailing. So now that we're all set, we're gonna bring you guys along for the ride. We have between 16 and 20 knots of wind from the northeast. It may turn a bit more east. We've got our sails set up for a broad reach. The waves were quite big, but have calmed down now, so it really is a nice ride. Got the main up. We have the second reef in because the winds were getting to 23 knots and just wanted to be super safe. And we have the screecher out, so it's a beautiful day. Along this route, we are passing the entrance to the Panama Canal. So all of the cargo ships that are en route, we actually have to pass by where they're entering and kind of exiting the shipping channel to get to the canal. So we've got to keep a really careful eye out and make sure that we're avoiding these ships. These are all ships, cargo ships. And these are the shipping lanes coming out, and it looks like we've got some coming out here, and this is us. So it's about 5:30 p.m. The sun will be setting in just about an hour. We had a squall come through. The winds got to 28 knots, so we had to quick furl the screecher. Unfortunately, I wasn't quick enough to grab a camera. So we pulled out the jib. The winds went back down to about 20 true, but we're headed into the night, so we figure we will just leave the jib and the main. The light this time of night is just so beautiful. But up on the horizon, we have some rain, and I can't really tell if it's coming towards us or moving away from us right now. So hopefully it's moving away, but we'll see.
Yeah, so there's this ship is coming pretty close to us. It's about half a mile on our port, and it's on a, really, it will be on a collision course. It's gonna come ahead of us, but it's pretty damn close. Look, MSC Arushi, sailing vessel Wanderlust, over.
Sailing vessel Wanderlust and go ahead, sir.
Are you going to pass ahead of us in a little bit?
Pardon, could you repeat your message?
I just want to make sure that you saw us. We're a half a mile on your starboard. Thank you so much.
If you're enjoying this video, give it a thumbs up, leave us a comment down below, and be sure to subscribe to the channel. It really helps us out.
Moving 18 knots, and he just went ahead of us about 1 mile across in front of our boat. So we're coming into the evening, we're gonna turn lights on and prepare for a night passage. We have second reef in, we have the jib all out, the wind is down to 17 knots, we're averaging 7 knots or so, with the wind just past the beam aft. And we're gonna do 3 hours on, 3 hours off overnight.
Well, this trip has not panned out to be as easy as we had hoped. Last night I was on shift, it was probably 1 a.m, the wind had gone down to about 10 knots and then it started slowly creeping up, 11, 12, 13, 17, and typically when it does this, I feel like, you know, we're gonna get socked, and I saw a big cloud overhead and all of a sudden we got a squall that came through to 40 knots of wind. Thankfully, we had the two reefs in the main and we had the jib out. So we waited. We were considering taking a third reef, but we waited. We figured the 40 knots wouldn't sustain. It didn't. Just after a couple of minutes, it went back down. So we were fine with the two reefs. And overall, the squall just lasted like 10 minutes or so. But it's, you know, it happens at night always. And yesterday we didn't show you guys, but when we were furling the screecher, one of the sheets got just totally wrapped around the sail as we were furling it, totally entangled, really just got beat up, and the line is pretty shredded now, so we're either gonna have to replace it or have it spliced. But that is sailing. You've got to expect things to break. You've got to expect complications and just deal with them, because once you get to where you're going, you're gonna forget about everything. And honestly, there were some really nice moments last night. We had moonlight, so there was light most of the night. And at times the sky was really clear, beautiful stars. I could see the Milky Way. So you got to take the good with the bad. And of course, today, early in the morning, the wind shifted from north, northeast to west, directly on our nose at, you know, 15, 17 knots. And so we tried sailing off the wind, you know, to go upwind, but it just added so much time to our voyage that we decided to turn on the engines and motor. So we're motoring directly there. We, instead of like the 24 hour passage though, because we've got waves and current against us, it's turning out to be more like a 30 hour passage. We're going directly to Isla Bastimentos and not stopping at Escudo de Veragas, because there's no cell service there. And we had a video go live today. We were hoping to have service when it went live, but we don't. And hopefully the rest of this passage is uneventful.
One Bay High. This is sailing vessel Wanderlust on your port side, over. Are we still good to go ahead of you, or should we go on your stern? Thank you. I didn't understand the first time around. Appreciate it.
A huge thank you to our patrons. We are so grateful for your support. If you'd like real-time updates and additional content, consider joining the Harbors Unknown community on Patreon.
He said, first time around, we're testing the engine. I'll maintain course,
I know.
So, interesting. Costco shipping. That's why we canceled our Costco membership.
We are almost there. I am so excited. We are approaching Isla Bastimentos and it's about 4 o'clock. We still have a little ways to go, probably another at least hour until we're anchored, but we're gonna anchor just behind Punta Bastimentos. There's an anchorage there recommended by the Bauhaus guide. So hopefully it looks good when we get around the corner. It looks nice and protected in about 26 feet of water. If not, we have backup anchorage. But the nice thing about this approach is that there's actually a channel there that we can go in. I think it's the Bocas channel, and then right around into the anchorage. Feels good to be stopped, huh?
Yes. That was a rough one.
It was super rough.
I haven't slept much.
Looking forward to a good night's sleep.
Hopefully, but yeah, this anchorage looks pretty good.
Cool. Are you happy? Are you happy? Are you happy, Yoli? Mwah!
We're here at Isla Bastimento in an anchorage. Very nice. It's recommended by the Bauhaus guide. We're in front of a nice village. There is other vessels around us and we would love to stay here. However, we read on Facebook groups and Noon site that there is a fair amount of theft in the area, especially dinghies and engines, but also people get on board and they've been reported theft of items on the boat. And we're a little concerned because of our equipment, cameras and computers, that we may lose some of that. So we're thinking about going to a marina, which is here nearby. It's called the Red Frog Marina.
Yep. Safety, security is definitely always a consideration when you're cruising around. You definitely have to take into your budget and your comfort. And so we are gonna head over to Red Frog. We've heard it's a great place. Everybody told us to stop there anyways. And then we will feel comfortable going for day trips with, you know, and not have to worry about things getting stolen off the boat.
Ready to roll?
Ready to roll.
I've said it many times, I know. I would change my ways, I know for sure. When all the crows decide to leave.
There's some reef on either side of this little bay, so I'm just making sure that I stay in the center of the channel. And then we'll be hooking a left.
Come sit here with me. by the fire and let it go for a little.
Red Frog Marina, Red Frog Marina. This is sailing catamaran Wanderlust, over. We are just passing the anchorage outside the marina and we'll be coming in shortly.
Okay, yeah, make sure you will go on the main dock or what's the gate.
Okay, dock, eh? Excellent. And so is that at the T dock, like on the end of the T dock?
The dock A, dock A.
Dock A? Okay, copy that.
See a person walking the dock.
Yep.
27 foot.
Yep, okay, there he is. Okay, we see somebody at the end of the dock waving at us.
So we're going to go in.
Okay.
22 foot. I don't want to go too close to the chitras, that's the only thing.
No.
When I was young, I thought control would lead me to an ending road. And heavy metal seemed to be the only thing that was. And I saw the angels coming down, and they sang a song and sang it loud. And I still remember parts of it, and the yellow glorious lid. Won't you be?
We're so excited to explore this area. If you haven't seen our Sandblast episodes, check out this video to see our favorite spots there.